Now I want to ask from you, how do you solve the previous year question? And how many of you are really solving the previous year question when you are following the daily target? How many of you are really solving the previous year question when you are following the daily target? Please reply in the chat box. And please reply everyone. I am getting reply only from 2-3 people, as if only 2-3 people are there in the class. This class is to be interactive. Okay, as soon as the topic is complete. But it is good that you are completing the previous year question, and that is to be there. But what is but? You have to solve in an effective manner. Okay, because if you see, 70% of the paper is repeating. 70% of the paper is repeating. So you have to really take care of the previous year question in a very systematic manner. So how to do that? Let me share with you. So this is the previous year question. This is my Kindle app. Okay, suppose so basically whenever you are solving any previous year question, please ensure that you are solving the one thing is that just drive the answer and move further. So one thing is that we read Dinesh Goswami committee, and it is about electoral reform. I take this and I move further and I am happy that I completed this. Okay, but that is not the best way. What you should do, if there are four options given over here, think about all the four options. Okay, which committee was there for denationalization of bank? I'm just telling you hypothetically. It is not always possible that all the options which are there, there is some information. But for example, this first statement, committee for denationalization of bank. I don't remember, but yes, there was some Narasimha committee in 1991 that talked about the privatization. I don't remember the name of the committee which who denationalized. So what I will do, I will underline this and I will left it open for the future, so that there is a vacuum in my mind that anytime I see this denationalization of committee, and I get to recall that this question has been asked previously. Because what will happen is, they have given the denationalization of bank. Next time they will ask the committee which recommended privatization of bank recently. So do you know which committee recommended the privatization of bank recently? And by the way, this question is of 1995, and there will be no surprise if this year in 2020 you get a question that which committee recommended the bank sector privatization recently, or on the recommendation of which committee the privatization happening recently. Are you getting how the UPSC drives the question? So rather than solving the new question, rather than solving the this test series, that test series, 5,000 question, 10,000 question, 15,000 question, solve the previous year question, solve in a manner you know each and every statement of the previous year question. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? How many of you are really getting what I'm trying to say? Please reply in the chat box. Okay. Only 3-4 people are replying. Rest of the people are just sitting and watching the session. This is not done. Siva, Raja, Nisha, Gitanjali, I never see your comment. Okay, anyway, so second is electoral reform. Okay, electoral reform mein kaun kaun si committee thi, which all committees were there in regarding the electoral reform. So there was one more committee, Inderjit Gupta committee, that was for the state funding of election. Which other committee was there? Means try to get into the depth of all the options. That is the best way. Then steps to put down insurgency in the Northeast. So which committee was there regarding controlling the insurgency in Northeast? If you are not aware, what you can do? You can do the Googling. जाइए गूगल पे सर्च कीजिए. आप तो वैसे भी गूगल पे बहुत कुछ सर्च करते हैं इरेलेवेंट चीजें, कम से कम यहाँ पे काम कीजिए तो सर्च कर सकते हैं. एंड दिस वर्क इफ यू कैन नॉट डू फॉर लास्ट 25 इयर्स, एटलीस्ट यू कैन डू दिस वर्क फॉर लास्ट 5 इयर्स एंड यू कैन डू दिस वर्क फॉर प्रीलिम्स पेपर्स एंड मेंस पेपर्स. नाउ आई एम कमिंग टू द न्यू डायमेंशन. जो मेंस का पेपर होता है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस ईयर देयर इज न्यू यू नो देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन अबाउट नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी in the health sector. So when you are reading science and technology, you have to be extra cautious in reading the nanotechnology in the health sector, because if they are asking some question in the prelims, sorry, if they are asking some question in the mains, there are chances that they will ask the same pattern, the same theme, the same question in the prelims also, and it happens many times. For example, they have very few favorite themes. Aadhaar, they will ask the question in the prelims also, mains also. Then stem cell, they will ask the question in the prelims also, mains also. GDP, prelims also, mains also. There are certain themes which they are repeating in the prelims and mains both. Again and again, again and again. So at least last 5 years, prelims and mains paper, all the question, all the statement, each and every line, you should be knowing why this is right, why this is wrong. Means you should be conceptually thorough with that. Even if you are able to solve the question in the first go, but again come back to the question and analyze each and every statement. I'm telling you, if you can do this work, even if you don't solve extra MCQ from our test series or any other test series, your examination is done. Okay, I getting your examination is done this year only. If you can do this work, this is a secret of qualifying the prelims exam, and just do this work with complete sincerity. For example, which of the following is or are stated in the Constitution of India? The president shall not be a member of either house of parliament. Okay. The parliament shall consist of the president and two houses. Now what you have to do, you will look into what is the correct statement of this. You know that this statement is right. But again, you will, look into, is there something else to it? The president shall not be a member of either house of parliament. So you will look into what are the qualifications of parliament. Now, sorry, what are the qualifications of president? Are you getting? So if there is a small dimension test in the previous question, you will go and look into the complete dimension or try to recall all the possible dimension. Okay. For example, this article 156, no governor can be removed from this office till the completion of his term. Then you will try to recall all the conditions for removal of governor, and in which all cases the governor can be removed. No governor can continue in the office beyond a period of 5 years. Means the point is, you go through the concept of governor in very, very detail. What are the eligibility criteria of governor? What are the disqualification criteria? When can he be removed? How much is his period? This is a simple example that I'm telling you. And the question will come from the governor multiple times, again and again, and they will ask the new dimension from the same topic or the same topic from same dimension in the new words. You don't need to practice 20,000 MCQ. You don't need to buy test series of so many institutes. No benefit. Yes, you can call it reverse engineering, whatever you call, but I will say master the previous year question. Even you just go through the Lakshmikant and the previous year question, your examination is done. Implement this technique and I can tell you, your examination is done. You will increase your marks suddenly in the test series also. Whichever test series you practice, your marks will increase suddenly because you are going in the right manner. That is how you are supposed to do the previous year question. And what people are doing? Okay, they go to this first question. The Dinesh Goswami committee was concerned with electoral reform. Okay, this is done, but this is not done. This is not, you never gave a thought to denationalization of bank. You never gave a thought to insurgency, chakmas, the problem of chakma. Okay, chakma ke baare mein aap dekh sakte hain ki okay, chakma, who is chakma, tribe kya hai, or where does it live? Is everything about chakma, and what is the best way? I am not saying that you unnecessarily do the unnecessary research at least what you can do, I'm showing it to you. Okay, so just look into the, what I did, I just type the chakma in the Google. Okay, so you type the chakmas and enter, and your Wikipedia will open. Now in the Wikipedia, what you have to do, just read this much of content. Only this much of content means only these two paragraph, the paragraph before the index part. जो इंडेक्स पार्ट के पहले का पैराग्राफ है, जस्ट इसको आप रीड करना होगा। The Chakma people are a native group from the easternmost region of the Indian subcontinent. They are largest ethnic group in the Chittagong Hill Tract region in southern East Bengal. Means, just read it like a layman. And if you find there is something which you didn't know earlier or something which you think is can be relevant, just write it down somewhere in your notes. Make a separate register of the previous question. And write it there. So this concept is prepared. This concept is done. Now there are chances that this chakmas would have been repeated at least 2 to 3 times in the paper. And if not repeated, that is not the criteria. I'm not saying that it will 100% repeat, but at least 65% to 70% of the UPSC prelims paper is repeated from the past concept only. Either the same question or some statement or some small term they picked up from the previous question and they gave in the new question. Are you getting it? So at least you can just read this much of content. Okay. But no, don't go beyond this. Okay. Don't try to master ki nahi is baat mein presence mein 150 marks leke aunga, 200 marks leke aunga. Nahi, utna bhi nahi karna hai yaar, utna bhi nahi jana hai aapko. Just starting 2 paragraph and that is more than sufficient. Okay. And don't try to think that I need to write now usko main yaad kar lunga ekdam ratte maar lunga iske nahi usna bhi zarurat nahi hai. Have trust on your mind. If you can read this in a very layman manner and can write only few point which you think you can forget later on, that is sufficient. No need to make the special notes of this, no need to do the further research, hai na. Don't get diverted from your target. अब ये नहीं है कि सर ने मैंने बोल दिया है कि प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन को एनालाइज करना है तो अब पूरा रिसर्च उसी पे कर डालेंगे, पूरे 5 महीने उसी पे लगा देंगे, ऐसा भी नहीं करना है. यू हैव टू मेंटेन ए बैलेंस, यू हैव टू नो वेयर टू स्टॉप. आर यू गेटिंग? यू डोंट हैव टू गो बियॉन्ड ए सर्टेन लिमिट इन एनी डायरेक्शन. दिस एग्जामिनेशन इज ऑल अबाउट बैलेंसिंग.